Morning YouTube, my name is Will, Lotus, and Enzo. All right, today's finally the day. We're going to get to experience Ralliart, and the ST's all clean, so I think we'll take it. All right. Oh, nice and clean. If you saw my last video, or I think it was the last video. I don't know when this will air exactly, but you know that I just washed this morning. Gotta beep for the pups. Oh, seriously? How hard is it not to block a driveway when you put the trash can back? For the pups' sake, I wanted to get out of the driveway and stuff before I took the time to put the radar up. So I did steal it back from the wifey, or from the Evo, to put back in wifey's car. Deacon. That just magnets in, which is nice. That is hardwired, in case you're wondering. It's got pulled out just now. I have to tuck it back, but it goes all the way up the A-pillar. Or no, that one goes down and down there. That one going up is for the dash cam. The dash cam actually isn't hardwired. So I don't know what I'm gonna title this video yet, because it's either gonna be titled, I finally get to drive a Ralliart and experience it, something to that effect, or it's gonna be titled, I try to experience a Ralliart. So what it is, the closest one I found is like 40 minutes away, because I have been checking these regularly, and I saw this one the other day and I was like, oh, that's a little farther than I want to go, and it's like a smaller dealership and everything. So I was like, I don't know, I kind of was debating it, but I'm going that way now. I'm gonna be like 8 minutes by GPS accordingly. From it. So I was like, all right, cool. We're gonna do it today. Hopefully they still have it. There is two of them for sale. There's a second one for sale that I don't like quite as much, but it's about 10 minutes away from where I'm going. Again, both, it's just funny that they're both kind of in the same part of town. So hopefully at least one of them has it. If the first one doesn't have it, obviously I'll go to the second one, and we'll kind of see how it goes from there. So if you watched the last video that I had dealing with the ST, you already know where this is headed, but just in case you didn't watch that video, we are going there, CarMax. All right, leaving CarMax, I do have the appraisal. If you haven't seen the last video and you want to know what it was, go check out that video. I'm up on this dealership now. I'm always a little nervous about small dealerships. I know there's plenty of them out there that are great dealerships. I just haven't experienced many of them. Not to say that I haven't seen some shady stuff at large dealerships, mind you, because I have. I'm pretty sure that's just a regular Lancer over there. Plus, I don't think it was that color. But I also don't remember seeing that one at all, so. If anybody's wondering, that is the color that our Evo 10 was. Oh, I think we found the Ralliart. Oh, how about that thing? Oh, there's the Evo over there. Oh, a little secondary entrance here. I didn't even realize. I was about ready to park there. All right, I'm gonna get out and look at the overall condition, because like I said, you know, first impressions mean a lot, and I don't want my first time driving a Ralliart to just be some piece of garbage. So if it just looks like crap, I don't wanna waste time driving it. I'm intrigued by the Evo though. I try not to be, but they draw me in. I'm just like, let's get the Evo. I don't know anything about it. I just want that one. So it's got an Evo style hood. I guess that's factory, no idea. It's kind of got like a smaller Evo style wing. Got Evo style dual exhaust, like a similar bumper. Oh yeah, good job Mitsubishi, we'll just tack that on. Ralliart, 14, 77,000 miles. Dual clutch. I think they all come with dual clutch. Or no? I guess it looks okay from the outside. Kind of what you'd expect from a 5-year-old used car. Let me know in the comments what you guys think this thing looks like. Those of you who have been around Ralliarts know more than I do. Had As a bonus, no salesman has harassed me yet, so let's go check out this Evo real quick. ST looks clean though. The wife hates him. I still like these wheels though. I'm not saying they're my favorite, but ooh, one series? Now see, that's the type of stuff I mean. Like, what is that? Oh, he's going to get the keys. He seems pretty laid back. All right, so 124,000 miles. It's been armor-alled to death. A lot of little nicks and stuff. Steering wheel's a little worn.
Drive either one of them.
Okay, thanks. Alright, let's at least come here for what we came for. Alright, it's my first time ever stepping foot in a Ralliart. So I know a lot of you have been telling me I should do this. So it's familiar, that's for sure. Interesting little sound on startup there. Stock exhaust. Stock exhaust tips anyway. Sounds stock. Looks stock. Does that look different? I wonder if this has been wrecked or something.
I'm curious. That looks awfully shiny. That's missing.
No, I guess the side's the same. Okay, never mind. I actually kind of like the black valve cover better. I don't know, I think this is in better condition than the Evo for sure. A lot less miles too though. All right, well, we'll let this warm up a bit and then take it for a little rip. Wanted to drive the Ralliart first, but somebody came to look at this as he was getting my ID and insurance, so it kind of forced my hand that I was going to need to drive this. Oh, four-wheel drive system. Oh yeah, he said there's a recall or something that they're going to fix, so I guess that's what he meant. So it's been a while since I've been in an Evo 10, that's for sure. An even longer while since it was a 5-speed. Can't go ripping right in front of the dealership, so which, I mean, we're not gonna beat on it, but definitely want to get a little feel for it. I would not seriously consider this car. I don't remember what they're asking for it, but obviously you know how I feel about buying modded cars. This doesn't seem to have a ton of mods, but the mods it has, I don't really like any of them. Sorry, I didn't have time to grab my real camera. Because, like I said, they kind of forced my hand. I was going to drive the Ralliart first, but when somebody shows up and wants to drive, sure as heck wasn't going to let it go. I gotta say, man, it pulls strong, though. It really does kind of make me want a 10 again. Yeah, it won't let me do anything with this. I definitely think we should get an Evo 10 again. It just feels right, you know? It's just like, it feels like it, like, it just feels right. This one doesn't. This one's a mess. But it feels right. Oh yeah, this will get you a speeding ticket real quick. Don't really know how to get back. I mean, I can turn around and go back, but kind of know where I'm at, but GPS got me here in a weird way, so. And I'm using my phone to record, so I can't really pull up GPS. I think this is just gonna circle me back though. Oh my gosh, how much I missed that. Not the car going like left to center, that's just me trying to drive and film and everything. Good brakes. Turn around. Shocks don't seem so great. That's the first major bump. Wow, can't go that way. Okay. I don't know. I keep saying I want an MR again, but I don't think I do. Definitely think I want a GSR. It was an Evo, but it wasn't. It was, I mean, no pun intended, it was kind of like an evolutionary change. Like, it, you know, felt like an Evo, but it didn't. This feels like an Evo, honestly. This thing is just, it's too rough. I mean, it's got so many questionable things, rust down there, brake calipers have been repainted. It's got a questionable mod choices. It's got some cheap looking carbon fiber that the clear coat's fading. I pulled into this gas station to get GPS and looky there. Ralliart. Well, if nothing else, I probably made the pressure on this kid and his mom way more serious. Because they're like, oh man, somebody's here to take the car that I drove all the way here for. All right, let it cool down a little bit. All right, I've got to put this here. I'm gonna drive the Ralliart. All right, that's the competition for buying the Evo. Not really. I just talked to him and told him that, look, like, you don't have to worry about it. I'm not a threat, which seemed like they weren't here anyways.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so normal, sport. Oh, there probably is no S sport on the Ralliarts. Okay, fair enough. Manual. So we can go down and up here, and then we have the paddles. All right, we're in tarmac. I forgot to get my camera again, oh well. All right, let's. All right, I'm actually kind of glad that the Evo was modded. It kind of reminds me of how fun it can be. Alright, to the best of my knowledge, this only comes in, the Ralliart only come with the SST. And if you're unfamiliar, it's a dual clutch transmission. Supposedly it's the same as the MR. I'm not 100% certain of that. Or, you know, if it is, maybe it's geared differently. I don't know. Okay, there we go. It's like, we need some AC in here. Way too hot. These seats suck, though. Well, as far as car seats go, they don't suck, but kind of like them better than the Focus is, to be honest. More comfortable. They have no bolstering whatsoever. What modes we got here? Tarmac, gravel, snow. Okay, so those are the same. Traction control, fog lights. All this is very MR-like. It's very identical, although mine was much cleaner, as you can imagine. Wow, you know, I gotta say, I was really expecting that to be disappointing after being in the Evo. Man, that transmission is just so phenomenal. It does seem very similar to the Evos. The biggest thing I can already tell, though, is not having the super sport mode. It's not as fast, especially in that 1-2 shift. The 2-3 shift was pretty quick. So it may be the same transmission. I don't know for certain, but it definitely doesn't have the seem to have the super sport mode. By all means, comment below if I'm wrong about that and I'm just missing it. Let me know. Get right in. Is that an M3? Yep. Or maybe not. Okay, we can beat you, Camry. Memory here, and I did just drive an Evo GSR, so you know, it's not as nimble. I don't have that quite that same like psycho turning ability. Of a blow off valve, maybe? I mean, it's factory, but just kind of like a hint. Oh, I still just want to hit the clutch pedal, though. I'm not even remotely going to drive this in automatic because I don't care about automatic mode, and I don't think anybody watching really does either. Wow, the speed limit's 25 on this road? I had no idea. Okay, we're gonna slow down a little bit. Because let's just say that was not 25. Selfie. Yeah, see, in the Evo, that would have been a much harder pull, obviously. That's a cop. Oh, and there's the guy who runs the dealership. So yeah, let's not do anything crazy here. It does look clean though. At least I know where I'm going now. It does look clean. Wifey should get an Evo 10 for sure. Case closed. not that I'm doing anything crazy. I think what I'm doing is perfectly fine. I'm not beating on the cars or like rev limiting them or anything like that, but still show a little respect for people who own them. Alright, reserves. There we go. Reverse. Oh, I got the reverse camera. Oh yeah, that's right. I pointed that out there earlier. It is handy, although very low quality. Comes this Evo again. Let's see if we can get a sound bite. Oh, that looks so good. I so want an Evo 10 now. All right, I'm gonna give him his keys, be polite, and get out of here. And then I'll give you guys my thoughts on this here in a moment. See you, that's nice. I forgot about that. All right, so let's go over some of my thoughts on the Ralliart and kind of how it compares to the Evo 10 GSR that I drove. You asked for me to do this review, which I was happy to comply with once I found a car. I will say this isn't a comprehensive like Lancer Ralliart review because that really wasn't the objective. The objective was just to kind of see how I felt it compared against Evos and just as a general car. If you want to know more about Lancers, I mean, it pretty much is the same inside as any other Lancer and or Evo. On to my thoughts. First, I want to say I was thoroughly impressed by how it drove, specifically how much acceleration it had. Thinking about it now, in retrospect, it's like, well, it is a smaller turbo, so it has more torque. So it makes sense that it felt that way. That combined with the dual clutch, completely logical of how quickly that car accelerated. And I shouldn't have been surprised, but I still was. Originally, I had planned to drive the Ralliart first. I thought that driving the Evo first would kind of taint it and just make it seem terrible, honestly. My hand was kind of pushed on that. So I had to drive the Evo first, but it actually ended up working out pretty well, I think. Because I went into the Ralliart after the Evo thinking, oh, this is just not gonna be good at all. And it was the complete opposite. I was very impressed. Really hammered home how similar these cars are, at least especially the drivetrain anyways. You know, if you want an Evo but you can't afford one, whether it's the car payment or the insurance or whatever, I could definitely see where a Ralliart would be a viable option. That all said, my drive was short in both of these cars. This was also the first review type video I had done on a car that wasn't my own. And to be completely honest, I really wasn't prepared for it properly. If I do any more like this in the future, I will definitely map out some better roads, some twisty roads, maybe some highway, you know, whatever suits the vehicle and whatever kind of I'm going for. Being my first time doing this, it was just, can I even find one? I found one. Awesome. Let's go drive it. Any experience I can get is better than the experience I currently have. Had I had time to prep and make some better roads and maybe had some more time, I think I would have found more and more fault with the Ralliart. You have to remember that the Ralliart is not a detuned Evo so much as it is a souped up Lancer. And there's a very big difference in that. Most of the drivetrain is the same or similar, close, but the body, the weight, the stance, the track, all that stuff is different and it makes a huge difference, obviously. Some better wheels, maybe some coilovers just to make it look a little bit better and handle a tiny bit better. I could definitely see this being a nice car to drive, or well, the Ralliart being a nice car to drive.
This would be nicer too though.
Oh, let's give it a little bit more of a throaty sound and you'd have a really awesome car, I think. But that's where I would stop. I've said in the past that I wouldn't suggest trying to get Evo performance out of a Ralliart, and I still think this holds true for some of the reasons I've said prior. You know, being that it is a souped up Lancer more than a detuned Evo, you're always going to have that weight difference, you're always going to have that structural difference, and the track is always going to be different. As well as the all-wheel drive system, I believe, is not quite the same. The transmission is, at the very least, it's tuned differently. So there's just a lot of things that you'll never get quite there. I've always loved Evos for their ability to handle, to put the power down and simultaneously handle, you know, especially coming from like Mustangs. prior. It was always such an awesome concept to me.
It was evident in even my short drive that the added weight and suspension differences, the Ralliart really couldn't do that. It was a fun blast at a straight line, but as soon as I got to turn a little bit in it, what little bit I could do, you definitely started to see the differences. It's certainly a fun car, and considering the price gap difference, I can definitely see why people are intrigued by them and why I get so many questions regarding them. In closing, if you want an Evo, but you can't really afford one, whether it's the car payment or the insurance or the upkeep, the Ralliart is definitely a viable option. You know, if you're looking for that stepping stone, absolutely. You know, if I was going back to my teens, early 20s, and couldn't get an Evo, and they had this car, absolutely. I mean, back then, when I was that age, they had the OZ Ralliart, which was just awful. Like, no. Alternatively, if you have an Evo, and you want some sort of daily driver, or maybe you have a car like an Evo, or just a car that you don't want to drive every day, necessarily, for whatever reason, you know, the Ralliart's certainly a viable option. They do share a lot of the same parts, and, you know, it's Mitsubishi, you know, it's the same family and everything. I could totally see somebody buying this as a daily or for their wife or for their kid. Absolutely.
If you guys have made it this far in the video, I'm assuming you're the loyal fans that watch all the videos. Oh, hey, buddy. So that would mean you know Enzo and you know Lotus, obviously. Yes. Okay, I will tell them. Yes, you have an Instagram and a YouTube channel now. Okay, are you happy? I told them. All right, we're good. We're good. Obviously, this was a new type of video for me, having never reviewed a car that wasn't my own. And I think it came out okay. I don't think it was the best. Hey, this way. I think it came out hopefully pretty good, but I can already see things through the edit. I've edited most of it already. And I can already see places where it's like, well, obviously I could do this better. And, you know, first of all, I could remember to bring the actual camera out of my car. That aside, I really appreciate it more than ever if you guys would comment below and let me know, one, what you thought of it. Two, if you want me to do these types of videos anymore, if you enjoy these types of videos from me. And if so, what other cars? And don't say things like Aventadors and, you know, no, I'm talking like normal cars, but there's not an official rule, but get what I'm saying. Like, you know, the Ralliart, that was perfect. That was easy one to do. Nobody's going to give you too much grief about wanting to go out and drive a Ralliart. Like I said, if you made it this far, I greatly appreciate you guys more than anything. And if you do like the video, this one especially, like it, but more than ever, comment and let me know the parts that you like, the parts that you didn't like, the parts that you'd like to see more or less of. I let the driving bits go for a while. I felt that it was good for this video, you know, because it's not a vehicle you see on the channel regularly, or for that matter, we'll ever see again. You know, there may be another Evo on the channel or something, but it won't be that one. You know what I mean. Anyways. So now that I've rambled on for quite a bit longer than I thought this would go, I just want to say once again, I appreciate you guys. Instagram links for myself and the pups below. If you need to ask me questions, my Instagram DMs are the best way to do that. As always, if I don't answer pretty quick, like, leave a comment like, hey, check your DMs, and that'll usually, I'll get those alerts. Other than that, there was something else. Oh yeah. So I've already shot tomorrow's video as well, and I think you guys will like it. Some updates for the Evo, and yeah, I think that'll do it. And it's a little early, but just so you guys know, when the shootout comes in August, I don't even know what date it is right now. It's just usually like in towards the end of August. I will be going. So if any of you are going to be going, if any of you are going or thinking you might go, you know, definitely let me know. It's up in Wakeman, Ohio, like I said, near the end of August. If you just Google search Busher Shootout 2019, it'll pop up, I'm sure. I generally just go up the Sunday of the races. But it does go for multiple days. They have, it goes like Friday, Saturday, Sunday at least. It might even go like Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. I don't know. They have all kinds of stuff. But anyways, if you're going to be up there, I plan on being up there. So with that, I'll see you guys tomorrow. Say bye. Say bye. Say bye. You're one and only. Uh-uh.